Good afternoon, students. Now we are going to study the remaining part of the social value topic, that is the attitude. Now regarding this attitude, the characteristics of attitude are going to be asked, factors responsible for change attitude will be asked in the exam, ways to change the attitude. So that is going to be asked in the exam. So from that point of view, the topic attitude is most important. First of all, we will see the meaning of attitude. It is feeling of like, attraction, interest toward other persons, objects, situation or ideas. Attitude means drishtikon, how you are going to look toward a particular thing, positive, negative, favorable, unfavorable. That is nothing but the attitude. So here it is say that feeling of like, attraction, interest toward other persons, objects, situation or ideas, that is called as attitude. Change in attitude may lead to change in actions. If you want to make a particular individual to adopt particular technology, for that we need to change his attitude. If you want to make particular person to carry out a particular action, for that we need to change his attitude. We must need to make a particular person to positive. By that way, he is going to do that particular action or activity. So what is the definition of attitude? According to G.B. Alport, attitude is a mental neutral state of readiness organized through the experience exerting or directives or dynamic influence upon the individual's response to all objects, situation with which it is related. It is a mental and neutral state of readiness. That is nothing but the attitudes. How that readiness is going to be occur? Organized through the experience exerting directives or dynamic influence upon individual responses. That means whatever the experience we gain, whatever the directions we gain, whatever the influences we are received from different responses, through that we are going to prepare a mental or neutral readiness of our mind. That is called as attitude. For example, if you get a particular negative experience from a particular person, after that your mind is going to become ready. Mental neutral states of readiness. Your mind is going to become ready, and by that way, you are going to say in a future that that person is a negative one, and you are not going to deal with that particular person if you get negative experience. Same thing regarding a person, regarding object, etc. Another definition, attitude can be defined as positive, negative evaluation of a people about object, event, activities, anything around the environment. Positive or negative evaluation of ourselves, people's regarding a particular object, event, activities. This one is good one, this one is bad one. By that we are going to evaluate a particular object, event, etc. That is nothing but that. It is the belief, feeling, action, tendencies of individual toward particular individuals, object, ideas or people. It is the belief, feeling, interest, action of the individuals toward particular object, ideas or people. So these are the three definitions of attitude out of which you can prepare anyone for the exam. Now the main part of this attitude is the characteristics of attitude. Number of characteristics are there, one by one we will discuss it. First one, attitude must an object. In definition, we have seen that a forming a feeling toward particular object, that is nothing but attitude. So attitudes are formed in relation to particular object, person or values. We are going to form the attitude toward particular persons, toward particular object. An attitude is a tendency to react positively or negatively in regard to an particular object. It is nothing but positive, negatively we are going to react to a particular object. For example, bike, car, anything is there. Here is an example is given. Person who has a positive attitude toward the religion is likely to enjoy the worship, service, beliefs of religious institution. And he tried to contribute in it. A person must be, if he is positive, but if he is having a negative attitude, he is going to avoid each and everything. Okay. Now second one, attitude must have directions. Direction, that means positive, negativeness. Attitude have direction, positive, negative, favorable or unfavorable, but it vary in degree. Positive is not 100% positive, somewhat 60%, 80%. Negative is not 100% negative, 60%, 70% might be, it vary in a degree, but it have direction, positive, negative, favorable or unfavorable. Attributes are organized into system, do not stand loosely separately. Attributes are organized into system. System, that means because of particular reason, because of particular experience, we are going to develop a particular positive attitude or negative attitude to a particular object. Then attitude develops through consistency among the responses. Only one response, positive or negative response, by that we are not going to form a positive or negative attitude. If you get a continuously positive response or continuously negative response, then we are going to form attitude, positive or negative attitude toward a particular object or person. They are more stable and enduring than opinion. Once attitude is going to form through multiple responses, they are becoming more stable and they are going to change our opinion. Attitude is not innate. Innate means by birth attitude are not going to form. They are not a natural one. Okay, but it is formed as a result of individual contact with the environment. Individual contact with the environment, that means as we get contact with particular person, as we get contact with particular object, as we get particular experience, by that way we are going to try to form the attitude. Attitude is rooted into motivation. Motivation of individual is totally dependent upon the attitude. If he is positive, then he is getting motivated and then he try to do that particular activity. But if he is negative, then no any motivation is developed and he is not going to perform that task. So here, it provides a meaningful background of individual's overt behavior. Overt behavior means physical action, which we are going to do, the activity which we are going to do. For that activity, to perform that particular task, attitude is going to form a meaningful background. Meaningful background, that means if you are positive, then you are going to perform it. But if you are negative, you are not going to perform that particular action. Attitudes are learned predisposition. Predisposition means kal tumcha, favorable unfavorableness. The attitudes we are going to be learned, that means attitude relevant to purchase of behavior are formed as a result of how the attitude are going to find that are going to find as a result of direct experience with the product, through word of mouth, that means we are going to hear information about that product from other persons, information acquired through others, exposure to mass media, advertisement, internet. Through this way we are going to form the attitudes, and by that way attitudes are predisposition, that means we are going to form positive or negative attitude toward a particular object, and then we are going to purchase that particular object or product. Attitudes occur within a situation. Situation means event or circumstances that a particular point in a time influence the relation between attitude and behavior. Event or circumstances, the activities that are going to be formed, that is nothing but situation which is going to form the attitude of the individuals. A specific situation may cause individual to behave in a way seemingly consistent with his behavior. That means if a situation is positive, we are going to carry out the actions. But if situation is negative, we are trying to avoid that kind of action. Attitudes are made to change. Once you form the positive attitude, it might change to negative also. If you are going to form negative attitude, we are able to change that negative attitude also. That means we are able to change the attitude. Attitude may bought or change in attitude may brought by trading or other instructional method. That means through education, through training, we are able to change the attitude of the people. Socialization helps in attitude formation. Socialization means mixing with society. It tries to develop your attitude. Attitude is related to the belief and social values. Belief means vishwas, the thing on which you are going to believe. By that way, we are going to form the positive attitude. Or the social values. Values, that means the thing which you feel important on. For that, you are going to form the particular attitude. Now, these are the characteristics of attitude. In exam, it is going to be asked. Now, another one, that is the way to change the attitude. How we are able to change the attitude? By obtaining new information from people, from mass media. Mass media means television, newspaper, magazines, books. Through that we are able to change the attitude. Direct experience with that particular object, direct experience with that particular situation, with particular person. Legislation. Legislation means laws and orders. By that way, attitude are going to be formed. Membership of a group and reference group. If you are going to become a member of a particular group, your attitude is going to change. If you are going to refer a particular group, refer a particular person, your attitude is going to be changed. Change differs with the reference to situation. How you are going to make a reference, with whom you are going to make a reference. By that way, we are going to form the attitude. So these are the ways by which we are able to change the attitude of the people. Now there are different factors in attitude change, or the factors on which the change in attitude is depend. In that, first one is the personal experience which we gain through a particular situation or with particular object. So direct experience with a particular object determines attitude of person toward particular object. A person experience of an individual, whether it is favorable or unfavorable, will affect his attitude deeply. Now this experience is most important. Personal experience is going to change the attitude, and that changes in attitude are formed deeply. For example, when we are going to visit a showroom to purchase a bike, at that time the showroom person tried to give you a trial. That trial is nothing but the experience, and this experience affect you and deeply affect your attitude. And once you become positive by that trial, you are supposed to buy that particular bike. That is personal experience. So attitude which are based on personal experience are difficult to change. Once due to personal experience attitude is going to form, you are unable to change that particular attitude. Okay, so one example is given that a person join a job which is recommended by him by his friend. Because of the recommendation of friends, he is going to join that particular job. But when he joined the job, he find work is repetitive, supervisors too tough, not cooperative, colleagues are not cooperative. He find that work is much more negative, repetitive one. He would develop, by that way he is going to develop negative attitude. Because the quality of his direct experience with the job is negative. Whatever the experience he gained, that become negative one. And he would develop a negative attitude toward that particular job. So that is the experience which he gained. Because of friend, he is going to join the job. But as he get a personal experience with that, during that, performing that particular job, he become negative one. Another one, influence of family and friends. The family and friends that are the most important person in our life, which are going to influence our attitude. Values, attitude like values are acquired from parent, teachers, peer groups and friend circle, etc. We observe the way our family friends behave, and we shape up our attitude and behavior aligned with their. That means we are going to observe our family persons, friend circles, and we try to shape up our attitude with their behavior. We try to change our attitude, we try to change our behavior according to the behavior of other persons. The change of attitude can come through the persuasion of friends or peers. The thing which we pursue means the thing which we understand from our peers, friends, by that way we are trying to change our attitude. Credibility of others, especially peers, is important to affect the change. Credibility means your belief on your friends, your belief on your family members. That is most important to change the attitude of the people. Peers with high credibility shall exercise significant influence as compared to the peers with low credibility. Peers with high credibility means the friends. Suppose friend circle, if you are going to believe much more on friend circle, then friend circle is able to change your attitude. If you are believing or having more credibility with your parents, then parents are able to change your attitude. So the credibility on which is more, that particular persons are able to change your attitude. That is family and friend circle, on which your credibility is much more. Then mass media. Mass media means the television, radio, magazines, newspapers. So all variety of mass community, television, radio, newspaper, magazines, feed their audience large quantity of information. We are getting large information, more information from these medias. Now mobile phone is also there, internet is also there. The presentation of news or information is constructed so as to cater the attitude of the audience. whatever the news are prepared, whatever the advertise are prepared through these different medias, that are only meant to cater. Cater means to attract the attitude of the audience, to change the attitude of the audience, to make the audience much more positive. Likewise, that advertise are going to be prepared. Advertising message attempt to alter the attitude of the people toward the certain product or service. The main aim of advertising is to change the attitude of the people. And once attitude is going to change, the actions of people are going to be changed. In an advertisement, if we are going to use actors, players, what they try to show that this actor, this player is using this product. By that way, our attitude is changed, and by that way, we are trying to buy that product in a market. So that is the way of changing the attitude of the people. Providing new information. New information will help to change the attitude. Updated information will able to change the attitude of the people. So negative attitudes are mainly formed because of lack of information. If you didn't have detailed data, detailed information, your attitude is going to be changed. Workers generally become pro-union because of ignorance about the good intentions of the managers or managements. Pro-union means workers are become against the union, against the company, because they are ignoring the good intention of the management. Once they come to know how the management care for their welfare, once they realize the management is working for ourselves, their attitude is going to be changed. This statement indicate that there is a lack of information because worker did not know the management is doing a work for them, management trying to taking care of them. But when they come to know that management is trying to take care of them, then their attitude is going to be changed. So detailed information, we must have detailed information. Use of fear. So fear can change the attitude. However, the change depends upon the degree of fear. Now, degree of fear means how? That is the level of fear. Low level of, moderate level, high level of fear. Fear helps to change the attitude of the people. Low level fear, people often ignore them. Moderate level, people change their attitude. And high degree of fear, if there is, people reject to change that particular attitude. Then co-opting approach. Co-opting means helping other people to change their attitude. Co-opting is another way to change the attitude of the people. This means taking people who are dissatisfied with the situation, getting them involved in improving the things. If you get a negative experience from particular product, also in that case, we have to motivate that people, we have to help that person to use that product in a better way so that he will get satisfaction. By that we are able to change the attitude of the people. Then oral persuasion. All the attitude techniques are not equally effective across the different situations. All techniques, all ways are not able to change the attitudes. They have their own ability to change the attitude of the people. But one of the most important way is to change the attitude of the people is the oral persuasion. Oral persuasion, that is just by a word of mouth. Just by explaining, we are able to change the attitude of the people. Oral persuasion techniques are most effective when use a positive and tactful tone. If we are using the positive tone, tactful tone, then we are able to change the attitude of the particular person. We need to present a strong evidence, strong examples. If we are going to tell the person strong examples, we are able to change the attitude of the people. Using logic to support your position. Whatever the thing we are trying to explain, if you are trying to give the reason for that particular thing, if you are able to give the examples that particular points, then you are easily we are able to change the attitude of the people. The next one, training session. Now, use of training session in which, what we can say, the employees share and personalize their experience. Employees are able to share their experience, practice the new behavior, can be a powerful stimulant for changing the attitude. That means through training sessions, by organizing training for the farmers, we are able to change the attitude of the people. So these are the different factors which are useful to change the attitude of the people. or playing important role in changing the attitude of the people. So in exam you might ask, define attitude, explain the characteristics of attitude, give the ways of changes of attitude, and also define attitude, explain the factors responsible for attitude change. So likewise the question will be asked in a final exam. Okay, so that is about the social value. Thank you.